You're not wrong. My mic was muted. My name is not Adam or Greg, though. Thank you for letting me know. That's embarrassing, because that's been a while. Hey, hi. Welcome to the stream. I forgot to unmute my mic. New to streaming. We're still learning a lot. I said, you're wrong. My name is neither Adam nor Greg, and you're quite a bit far. Yeah, I'm just getting back into it. I used to draw when I was younger. Tonight I'm kind of just playing around and trying to do different expressions and try to do some different stuff there. But I only recently got back into drawing back at the end of November. So a little over a month. I started to draw again, and pretty quickly after I started, I decided to start streaming since I had the technology available. And since Twitch rolled out Creative not too long ago, it seemed interesting and it seemed like a good way to keep me drawing and keep me interested in it. So far, it has definitely done that. This is the third stream this week. This stream is a little more experimental than what I've been doing. I'm focusing on expressions here and trying to do different ones, whereas in the other streams this week I was drawing a character. Yeah, I'm really happy with Twitch Creative, and I've had nothing but good experiences so far. But I was a little concerned that, like, people would be difficult, and I certainly don't have an enormous viewer base or anything, and that kind of comes with the territory, but so far everyone has been really nice and very encouraging. So we have been going for about an hour, and I'm starting to run a little bit out of ideas of random expressions to do here. So I'm going to take a short break, no more than 5 minutes, and I will be back with maybe something a little different. Back in a bit. All right, and we're back. This time the mic is not muted because people in chat are nice. Thank you. So let's go over what we've done. Yes, all the way back here. All right, so since you didn't hear it at the beginning of the stream, I decided to be experimental with this one, and we started doing different expressions. I wanted to try to draw a bunch of different ones to start off and then figure out where we were going from there. So I started off, and the first one ended up kind of small, but just with a generic happy expression. Moved on to this one, which was sad, but kind of just like mildly upset. Went down here, did angry, flip page. Started getting only two page here. I went for surprised, and I'm like, well, can we make that? Happy surprise. Look back, and kind of like a disdainful, like, ew, that's gross kind of look. And this turned into a scared, sort of suspicious kind of thing. Not the scared where, like, that thing is going to murder me. We're like, I'm uncomfortable with this situation. Flipped over here, I got kind of like a quiet happiness, which is called content. Down here, I went for kind of an impatient look where you're like, you're annoyed, is kind of another way to put that. And over here, I got this embarrassed kind of look, but it's more of a happy embarrassed than an I just did something dumb. So, more like somebody has given me an unexpected compliment, then I left the mic muted on my stream for over, well, for almost an hour. Yeah. I flipped over here. We did tired, which I said is my default kind of expression. And then we did suspicious right before we went on break. So now, another blank page. I honestly am not all that sure of what to do. So I think what we're gonna do is I'm going to start to draw an expression, but rather than work through it quickly, like we've been doing, I'm going to try to spend more time on it and kind of flesh it out a little bit better. So let's see. I guess to start, let's spend a little bit more time on our actual shape here. I'm gonna make this one pretty big. We're gonna have it take up. I'm not gonna get anything else on this page, basically. For something a little more realistic here. It's still gonna be stylized. So in general, I'm spending a lot more time on the details this time. I'm actually gonna draw this hair out in the way that I like. Way off frame there, sorry about that. I'm just having a lot of trouble with the actual streaming part of my stream tonight. I suppose the focus is more of the art, but I'd like for you to be able to see it while I'm doing it, and hear me while I'm talking about it. Oh, I'll get there. This is what I like to do with hair. I like to draw out the shape, do a whole bunch of lines to show its direction, and then smudge it a whole bunch. The result is that you get the shape of the hair, and you get the flow of the hair, which I follow around as I'm doing this. You don't get nearly as many hard lines, and it evens the tone out a lot. That's just a thing I like. Ends up looking kinda like that. little more realism this time. I like to mix some realism elements in. Say that there's a thing that's been going around on Twitter. It's probably passed by now, but following, the social media stuff is always difficult. I'm usually not the most up on all of that. But there's a thing going around that is a thing a lot of artists are posting. Mostly got a follow on Twitter. It says, describe my art style. And it's an interesting look to be like, oh, what do people recognize about your style? What do they think makes your style unique versus what you think makes your style unique? And somebody posted about it, and it's like, I see a lot of newer artists saying that they would do this, but they worry that they don't have a style, like that their style isn't recognizable. It's like, you don't need to try to cultivate a style. As you're going about drawing, you're going to develop one. So, you don't need to worry much about whether or not you have style, because you do, even if you don't recognize it. And I saw another post that, I don't remember the exact wording, which is a shame, because it's really good. But the idea was like, when you're drawing, everything that you're doing, everything that we're doing here, no matter what your style is, no matter how much realism you're trying to do, is you are trying to use symbols to represent what you perceive. So you can't literally draw a 3D object here. So you're trying to represent it using 2D symbols. No matter how detailed you are, no matter how much you're trying to aim for realism, you're still being symbolic. It's like there's no wrong way to draw the way that you see something, the way that you interpret it. Another thing I like to do is with eyebrows, actually make them a bunch of hair. There. Rather than just lines. Alright. So, we spent more time on this one to kind of draw this out. Still very stylized, but a lot more soft shading, a lot more time spent on a lot of the details. And I think we're going to leave it there for tonight. It's a little bit of a short stream. It's only about an hour and a half. You don't get to hear me talk for most of it, but I think that for tonight, unless I find something else I want to do later, that this is where I want to stop. So there we go. Just a little recap here. What we did tonight is we did some work on expressions. I started by drawing a whole bunch of them, and then we took a quick break and came back to focus deep on one. Took up the whole page with it and tried to fill in a lot more of the details, do a lot more blending, shading, that kind of stuff. Still kept it pretty stylized. I wanted to keep it as a sketch, and I'm pretty happy with it. It's definitely something that I could do better if I were using references, if I were trying to work from something, but as far as a measure of what I can pull off just from memory, I'm not too upset with this. Like I said, a lot to learn still, but that's alright. But I think that's where we're going to leave it tonight, so thank you very much for joining me. I'm sorry about the microphone problem earlier, and I hope you will tune in again.